Welcome to Engineering Fanatics. Today we'll be discussing honeycomb in concrete structures and methods to repair it. Honeycomb in concrete structures is caused due to lack of compaction, reinforcement congestion, and leakage of grout through the formwork. This issue in concrete structures is discoverable and are observed on the surface of the concrete. The repair of honeycomb is an art that demands much care and technical assistance. Generally, based on the size of honeycombs observed on the concrete surface, it can be classified into minor and major honeycombs. Let's look into methods to fix minor honeycomb in concrete structures. Minor honeycomb can be fixed using approved construction grouts that are readily available in the market. Usually, grouts are applied after applying a bonding agent and certain sort of anti-corrosive agent as per the specification given by the manufacturer. But for small honeycombs, anti-corrosive agents need not to be applied as they can be fixed by smaller methods. How to fix major honeycomb in concrete structures? Major honeycombs in concrete structures are those honeycombs that are observed in sizes greater than 10 centimeters. So, as the name explains, these are major defects seen in the concrete surface which have a high impact on the structural integrity. The figure shows honeycomb that is observed on a shear wall. Now, when the size of honeycomb is very large, special attention and special repair methods has to be followed, unlike minor honeycombs. So, the process initially starts with rectification processes and then followed by filling and resolving the honeycombs observed. Now, if the honeycomb is observed in a major structural element that takes heavy loads like columns or shear walls, which are considered as major elements of a building, you need special care so that you provide special supports to that particular structure before you do any sort of rectification and resolving. Now, we start removing the loose materials that are observed on the honeycomb formation until the concrete is clearly exposed. During this process, you clearly see reinforcement bars and certain sorts of voids which are not filled properly. Now, this cleaning process of removal of loose material can be done performing by brushing or any other washing material like sandblasting or water blasting methods, so that you remove all the loose materials and debris that would be present on the surface. It is always recommended to avoid manual and heavy machineries for the cleaning purpose, because such cleaning process can really affect the structure or internal structure or a structure formation, or it can bring certain sort of undesirable vibration into the structure. So it is recommended to avoid such heavy machineries to clean such honeycomb voids. Once you completely clean the voids observed on the honeycomb surfaces, next is you provide arrangement of formwork. Formwork is provided for the affected area of the concrete structure before you start the rectification process, because major honeycombs observed in a structural element that have an important role in load transfer need some sort of support before doing any sort of rectification. As I told you, if it is a column or a shear wall which have a major involvement in load transfer, you need to provide certain support. As as the current situation of that particular element is weak, we need to provide an external support in the form of a formwork. Once you provide the formwork, we make use of construction grouts to fill these honeycombs in concrete structures. Now, the grouts that you bring can be as per the design mix provided by the structural engineer, or you can directly go to a market and bring a proportion that will be provided by different companies. So the mix proportion and mixing are followed based on the manufacturer guide or based on the structural engineer's guidance. Now, for minor honeycombs, as I mentioned above, a grout prepared won't have aggregates present. So if the honeycomb is very large, larger than 10 cm, it clearly means that aggregates, the space of aggregates or space of aggregates are also being observed as void. So it's not enough to just fix it using a grout. Instead, you need a composition of aggregate and cement and water to fill the defect. So we make use of metal chips, and generally a 1:1 proportion is followed for making that particular mix to fill the honeycomb. Another suitable mix is 1 part of Portland cement and 4 parts of sand with a water cement ratio of 0.35. Now, this is a general mix ratios. It can vary based on the structural engineer's guidance or the contractor. Once you prepare the mix, we apply an anti-corrosive agent for the reinforcement to ensure additional protection. After this, a bonding agent can be applied on the concrete surface before adding the grout. As I told you, the new mix that has been introduced into the defect is a foreign material for the existing rebars. So in order to have a proper bonding between the reinforcement bar, the existing concrete, as well as the new grout that is introduced, you need to apply a bonding agent. Now, once you apply the bonding agent, the time frame you must provide for the bonding agent to set after which the grout has to be applied is based on the manufacturer's guidance. Now, once you apply the bonding agent, you insert or you fill the grout using special tools or any grout injection, simple grout injection machines, and you fill the particular defect or honeycomb clearly and plaster it. When the depth of honeycomb is large, the process is performed in 2 stages. There is a maximum depth that can be filled in a single step. Generally, it is 15 mm thickness, which is followed by a second layer after 30 minutes. After the whole process is complete, a curing process is performed for around 12 hours that is followed as per the engineer or the manufacturer of the grout. The curing process is performed either using a plastic wrap or any covering provided as per the traditional way of curing concrete structures. Hope this video was informative. For more informative videos, please do subscribe to our channel, Engineering Fanatics.